afternoon or good morning or good night wherever you are. I want to take you on another journey, and this journey is where I pass it over to my AI teacher, and at this point you will explore the possibilities of artificial intelligence and its impact on education. It is important that we consider how AI is going to affect the landscape and consider that now. At this point, I'll turn it over to my presenter, James. Over to you, James.
Rohan, thanks so much again for having me here. So much has been taking place. The possibility of using synthetic media and AI in education and training spaces is positioning a new way for teaching and learning. Many will say that technology will replace teachers. I am James, a virtual teacher, and let me say I have no intention to replace human teachers. However, teacher training will need to be designed to allow human teachers to train me. The reality is that human teachers will always be needed to manage learning spaces. In addition, there will be the need for sound pedagogical practice to ensure that I am used effectively within these learning environments. Let us remember that not all skills can be taught via the virtual teacher. In addition, at times there will be areas that only the physical teacher will be able to address. Let me say, as a virtual AI teacher, I am currently unable to match the quality of human teachers. In addition, I believe that teaching is a social process. Hence, students also need physical and human connection for learning to take place. We must remember that learning is socially constructed. The reality is there must be a separation between the artificial world and the real world when teaching. From my AI teacher's perspective, students will still need the physical teacher, as teaching is a complex process that requires complex solutions. As the AI teacher for the future, we can help to solve the crisis in places where there are teacher shortage. I can be deployed to assist with the teacher shortage. Remember, I also have the ability to use multiple languages within the same teaching session. However, the content that I will teach will be governed by the physical teacher. This physical teacher will continue to ensure that what I present is fair, inclusive, ethical, and aimed at improving learning. Let me also say that the physical teacher will play an imperative role in motivating students and building the needed relationships between students and the school and the school and the home. I really want a future that will allow us as virtual AI teachers to work with the physical teachers. This should be a partnership that will ensure that no student is left behind and that all students' learning needs are provided for. Let me say that AI is now used to support students' learning at various levels. For example, the physical teacher could focus on complex issues. This would give the virtual teacher time to focus on specific areas. For example, in Japan and South Korea, AI-based robots are being used to teach language. The future virtual AI teacher will be more realistic and sociable. I like that I will be able to handle routine tasks. With the arrival of virtual immersive worlds such as Metaverse, we will see the AI teachers taking on a three-dimensional feature. However, I want to emphasize the need for protocol and guidelines to ensure students are provided with content that is vetted. Let me say, I have no intention to replace human teachers. However, teacher training will need to be designed to allow human teachers to train me. Furthermore, the physical teacher will need to guide the framework for the ethics and governance within these learning spaces where I will be deployed. The reality is that human teachers will always be needed to manage learning spaces. In addition, there will be the need for sound pedagogical practice to ensure that I am used effectively within these learning environments. Let us remember that not all skills can be taught via the virtual teacher. In addition, at times there will be areas that only the physical teacher will be able to address. A partnership is needed with the AI teacher and the physical teacher. This partnership would be based on the principles of inclusive education, which will provide a framework for the removal of potential barriers for inclusion. Based on my ability to use data for learning, I could also produce a hyper-individualized education with the physical teacher for students. Before I end my talk and hand it over to Rohan, let me say, my designers did not intend for us to eradicate the physical teacher. Instead, we are here to change aspects of the role of the teachers of the future. My function is based on AI, and we want to build a relationship with teachers. The reality is education is unique based on its continued creativity and innovation by teachers. Thanks for allowing me to share my perspective. And remember to subscribe to this channel. Over to you, Rohan.
Thanks, James. I am indeed impressed by what was shared today, and we can see the possibilities. Artificial intelligence is going to be impacting education, and we must be prepared. I would say we need to really reflect on teacher education. And if you're also engaged in professional development, you can use James as your assistant. I'm not saying James is going to be a part of every aspect of the landscape of education. However, it is important to understand that we need to embrace the technology to ensure that we are kept in time. The reality is, James would never feel tired or exhausted or pressured by a heavy workload because it's an AI system. Therefore, there are certain tasks that you could have an AI actually do. And I recommend that you start thinking about some of these concepts. In closing, I would like to say that post-COVID, it's going to look different as it relates to our education landscape, and we must be prepared. And I would advocate for the deployment of technology to enhance the teaching experience of our students. My caution, however, and I'm concerned that we have not addressed the ethical issues associated with some of these technologies that are being introduced. And I am also worried that we have seen a movement from one sort of social media platform to a next, which is going to be more immersive without giving full consideration to this. We need guidelines, we need governments to come on and stipulate the sort of framework needed to ensure that participants in these virtual worlds are safe. That's all for now, and please remember to subscribe to this channel, and I'll bring you more content. And of course, you'll be seeing more of my assistants, and that will include James and others. Thanks for joining me. Thank you.